Hello guys, it's Deep Show here, and today I'm going to show you a simple method on how to give this cartoon effect to your photos in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool things using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So this is the model image which I'll be using in order to create a cartoon effect. Now if you want to use the same image, then the download link for this image is in the description below. So the first step over here we will be doing is creating a duplicate of this image by pressing Ctrl plus J, and then hide the original background layer by clicking on this eye icon over here. After that, select quick selection tool. And then using quick selection tool, select the model in the image. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. Now if you want to deselect a selection, then you can click on this minus brush icon. And then using that brush, hover over the selection which you want to deselect. Now if you again want to select something, then click on this plus brush icon. So now once the selection looks proper, after that click on refine edge. Now after that, using the brush, hover over the portion of the hair to make it look more smoother. Now once the selection looks smooth, after that click on OK. After that click on add layer mask icon, which will only keep the portion of the image which is inside of the selection, and then remove the rest of the image. After that, right click inside of the mask of the image and then select option apply layer mask. After that, we need to create a new document, so for that go to file and then select option new. After that, set the width as 1920 pixels, set the height as 1080 pixels, and then set the resolution as 200 pixels per inch, and then click on OK. After that, again go to the original model image document, and then select Move tool, and then using Move tool, drag this model image into our new document. After that, press Ctrl plus T. Now let me just zoom out of the image. Now after that, we need to scale down this model image so that it fits into this document properly. So for that, press shift and drag from the corner as follows. Also make sure that you place the model image at the center of the document and then click on the stick icon to place it. After that, we need to set a gradient color for the background of this image. So for that, make the background layer active by clicking on it and then click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option gradient over there. After that, set the gradient as black and white. And then after that, click on this gradient icon besides the drop down over here, which will give you a new pop-up. And then over that, double click on the left bottom color stop, which will give you the option to change that color. And then set the new color as 004151. And then click on OK. After that, click on OK. And then set the style as radial, angle as 25 degree, scale it to 110%. And then click on this reverse option. After that, click on OK. Now after that, we need to merge the gradient layer and the model image layer into a single layer and convert that layer into a smart object. So for that, press Ctrl and click on this model image layer, which will give you the selection of the model image layer as well as keep the selection of the gradient layer over here. After that, right click over there and then select option convert to smart object. So as you can see, we have merged the two layers and converted that new layer into a smart object. Now after that, we need to create three duplicates of this smart object layer by pressing Ctrl plus J three times. Now after that, rename the top layer as Cartoon 3, the layer below it as Cartoon 2, the layer below it as Cartoon 1, and the layer below it as Backup. In case we do something wrong, we won't have to start from scratch. After that, make the Cartoon 1 layer active by clicking on it, and then hide the Cartoon 2 layer and the Cartoon 3 layer by clicking on the eye icon over here. So now after that, go to filter and then select option filter gallery. After that, expand the artistic folder and then select option posture edges. After that, set the edge thickness as 0, edge intensity as 0, and then set the posturization as 2. So now after applying the filter, your image should look something like this. After that, click on OK. After that, let's sharpen the overall image and give some contrast to the image over here as well. So for that, go to filter and then sharpen, and then select option unsharp mask. After that, set the amount as 80%, set the radius as 5 pixels, and then set the threshold to 10 levels, and then click on OK. Now let me just show you the effect of this unsharp mask by clicking on the icon. So as you can see, we have increased the details of the overall image and added some contrast to the image over here. After that, again go to filter, and then select option oil paint. So now if your Photoshop does not contain this oil paint filter, then we have created one video where we have applied this oil paint effect without using the oil paint filter. So the link for that video will be there in the card above and in the description below. So now after that, set the stylization as 4, set the cleanliness as 3, set the scale as 0.1, and then set the bristle detail to 0, angular direction to 0, and shine to 0 as well. After applying the oil paint filter, your image should look something like this. After that, click on OK. So as you can see, after applying the oil paint filter, image has started to look like a cartoon over here. So now after that, let's again bring up the details of the image and add some contrast. So for that, again go to filter and then sharpen and then select option unsharp mask. After that, reduce the amount to 50%. Keep the radius as 5 pixels and then reduce the threshold to 5 levels. And then click on OK. Now after that, make the cartoon tool layer active by clicking on it and then unhide it by clicking on this eye icon. Now for this layer, again go to filter and then select option filter gallery. After that, select the option posture edges and then set the edge thickness as 0, increase the edge intensity to 1 and then increase the posterization to 6. Now after applying the effect, your image should look something like this. After that, click on OK. After that, again go to filter and then sharpen and then select option unsharp mask. After that, reduce the amount to 10% and then keep the radius as 5 pixels and the threshold as 5 levels and then click on OK. So now after that, let's apply the oil paint filter. So for that, go to filter and then select option oil paint. Now keep the settings of the oil paint filter same as we did for the previous layer and then click on OK. After that, change the blend mode of the layer to soft light. Now let me just show you the effect of this overall cartoon tool layer by clicking on this eye icon. So as you can see, by adding this layer, it gives such a nice touch up over here. After that, make the cartoon 3 layer active by clicking on it and then unhide it by clicking on the eye icon. Now for this layer, go to filter and then other and then select option high pass. After that, set the radius according to the details of the image you want over here. As you can see, as you increase the radius, the more details of the image will be visible. But over here, 3 pixels look good. And then click on OK. After that, let's apply the oil paint filter to this layer as well. So for that, go to filter and then select option oil paint. And then keep the settings of the oil paint as same and then click on OK. After that, change the blend mode of the layer to soft light. Now let me just show you the effect of this overall cartoon 3 layer by clicking on this eye icon. So as you can see, this cartoon 3 layer is giving such a nice subtle touch over here. Now after that, let's increase the saturation of the image a little bit. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option vibrance. After that, set the vibrance to 100 and then increase the saturation to 25 and then minimize it. After that, change the blend mode of the layer to linear light and then reduce the fill to 10%. Now let me just show you the effect of this layer by clicking on this eye icon. So as you can see, by increasing the saturation, the image is looking so good. Now after that, as you can see over the face and the neck portion over here, the curvy lines of the oil paint filter is quite visible. Let me just zoom into the image and show you what I'm talking about. So as you can see, these curvy lines are visible over here, which is not looking good. Now let me just zoom out again. Now in order to solve this, we need to merge all the layers into a single layer. So for that, press Ctrl plus Shift plus Alt plus E. So now as you can see, all of our layers have been merged into a single layer. So after that, go to Filter and then Blur and then select option Surface Blur. After that, set the radius as 30 pixels and threshold to 15 levels and then click on OK. Now let me just show you the effect of this surface blur filter by clicking on this eye icon. So as you can see, by applying this surface blur filter, the curvy lines of this oil paint filter is no more visible. So that's it guys, this will give you your cartoon effect in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.